I'm at the Cow Heaven Trailhead, very close to the Marblemount National Park Ranger Station. Bit of a cloudy day today, probably going to be camped up in the fog later. So the plan today is to hike this trail up to where I'll be camped up in the meadow, about 4,000 feet up from the trailhead. It's going to be a pretty hard hike because I got to load up quite a bit of water a little ways up this trail here, because that will be my last dependable water. And the first of a jillion switchbacks. After about 90 minutes of hiking, I'm reaching this last crossing of the trail over the creek, and also the last reliable water on this trail. So I'm gonna stop here and fill up my water bottles. I'm back on the trail again. Pack's about 10 pounds heavier. Made it to this little meadow. This is Cow Heaven. And here's where I'll be camping. So I have a little bit of cell reception up here, and looking online at the latest forecast, it's not looking really good for tomorrow. Probably more of the same, maybe even some rain. I'm still gonna go explore a little ways up here towards at least the southwest Helen Butte. There's two Helen Buttes, southwest and northeast. Northeast being the somewhat higher one and harder to get to. I don't want to go too far off trail in this fog. I'm not minding the fog too much right now, though. It's not terribly cold, and it's a little damp, but it's not raining or anything. It made the hike a lot more pleasant today because I broke a pretty good sweat anyway, even hiking in the fog. And I'm out here camping, and it's hard to have a bad time camping unless you get injured or something. Well, one thing about this camp is there are tons and tons of ripe blueberries everywhere. The fog has cleared a little bit around the camp, probably not for long. You can see a little peak up here. On the right side of that, this trail heads up that way. It actually continues beyond that, up towards the southwest Helen Butte. And that is where I turned around when I was up here last time, 3 years ago. It's actually a very good viewpoint from that spot. That is when it's not fogged in. Anyway, yeah, tomorrow, fog or not, I'm gonna at least follow the trail as far as I can past that. Well, the clearer view did not last for long. It's getting darker, a little chillier. Probably gonna crawl in the tent and call it a night soon. Well, this morning, I'd say the fog's even a little thicker than it was last night. Well, it's getting on towards 1 p.m. I'm not seeing any sign of that cloud lifting. So I think I'm just gonna go ahead and see how far I can go up here. So other than right there at my camp, this is pretty much all of the meadowy area, the so-called cow heaven. I think I read somewhere that natives first cleared this area so that the berries would grow. And then later, local cattle ranchers used to bring their cows up here for the summer, come back and get them in the fall. So here, within 100 yards or less of the camp, trail forks. This left fork, it goes into brush pretty quickly, and I don't know, maybe it used to go somewhere, but it doesn't anymore. So we're gonna go right. Well, I haven't seen any bear sign at all anywhere on this hike, but this certainly seems like the kind of area they would like to hang out. So the trail's gonna cut into the woods here and eventually gonna end up on the other side of this spine going uphill. Southwest Butte is just a little ways up here. We'll see how close I can get. So this is the place, last time I was here 3 years ago, I got off trail, or I should say off this climber's route, climbed up right over here, and I was able to see a forest fire going on probably close to 25 or 30 miles away, way up Cascade River Valley, and the phone reception here, so I was able to call it in. But yeah, this is where I turned around. I was only on here as a day hike, and that was quite a bit. I'll just even up to this point. From here on, this is new exploration for me. Every time I'm entering a brushy section like this, I start saying, "Hey bear, hey bear," because I don't want to scare the bear. And I don't want to have the bear scare me. Route's a little indistinct, it's taking a sharp left. And I can't tell if it's this way, I think so. It's probably not up those rocks, so I'm gonna guess this way. Hey bear, hey bear. I think this is it. Wow, it's so brushy though. Huh. I almost lost the route here. A little bit of a bushwhack. Coming down, this is gonna be interesting because this wet brush is kind of slick. Well guys, I think I'm gonna turn around. It's getting really steep and it's getting brushy. And also the route's not clear. I don't need to be getting lost up here in the fog. I'm bushwhacking my way back to civilization. It might be a little treacherous going down even from here. I think if I ever come back up to do this again, I'm gonna bring a GPS. I've already had to sit down just to get down some of this. And the actual route, it's not real easy to see. I know I need to go down this way. And back to where the path's a little more obvious. I would have liked to have made it up there, but you know, with no views and all, the reward to risk ratio, just not worth it for me. Those of you that have been watching my videos for a while probably know that I won't hesitate to turn around if I get to a point where I feel it's becoming unsafe. So that's kind of what happened today. You know, if I were to come up here in better weather, GPS would be a good idea. I think it would be quite feasible. Yeah, I'm not regretting that I came here, even though conditions are far from ideal. And this was the time I had to get out, and I'm out. I'm here. Cloud seems to have lifted just a little bit. The view is right up there. I think I made it maybe halfway there from here. It's drizzling a little bit. Well, it's getting wet enough. I'm gonna climb in a tent. It's 8 a.m. I'm leaving cloud heaven, I mean cow heaven. Yeah, it's almost a view. This first section down the trail, kind of not very fun. I'm getting soaking wet here. Okay, I think I'm working through the worst of the brush now. Water soaked down my pant legs, down my socks, and now I'm walking on sponges. Squish, squish, squish. Reaching this creek after about a little over 90 minutes of hiking, making pretty good time. I think it took me about twice as long to get up from this point. So it puts me a little less than 2 miles from the car. I didn't notice this marker before. Oh, 1 mile from the trailhead. Getting back to the car. Well, it took me a little less than 3 hours to come down. much easier than going up.